أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم My name is Afaq Ahmed Khan from Comsys University Islamabad Wa campus and I am studying BS in Computer Science from section C1 So here is today the topic is about the history of Waziristan Let's move towards the contents the contents we have introduction Waziristan divisions North Waziristan South Waziristan revolt Fakir of EP, War of Terror, Conclusion and then References. First of all, we are about to study the introduction. Waziristan lies between the Kurram River to the north and the Gomal River to the south. It is bordered by Banu and Tang districts, FRDI Khan and Kurram Agency to the east and northeast, Shirani and Musakhel districts of Balochistan to the south in Pakistan. And host Paktia and Paktia provinces of Afghanistan to the west and north. Let's move towards the Waziristan's division. Waziristan is divided into two agencies, now districts of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province of Pakistan, North Waziristan and South Waziristan. According to 2017 census of Pakistan, the population of North Waziristan is 5,43,254. While that of South Waziristan is 6,74,065. The two parts have quite distinct characteristics, though both are inhabited by the Wazir tribe, they have a reputation as formidable warriors. Let's move towards the North Waziristan. North Waziristan's capital is Miranshah. The area is mostly inhabited by the Dawar tribe and the Utmanzai branch of Darvesh Khel Waziris. Who are related to Ahmadzai Waziris of South Waziristan who live in fortified mountain villages including Razmak, Datakhel, Spinwam, Dusali, Shawa and Shawal. The Dawar are also known as Daur or Daur, who live in the main Tochi Valley farm in the valleys below in villages including Miranshah, Hamzoni, Darpakhel, Muhammad Khel, Boya, Degan, Banda, Ngarkali, Plangzai, Mirali, Idak, Hurmaz, Musaki, Hasukhel, Ziraki, Tapi, Isodi, Hedrakhel and Khadi irrigated by the river Tochi. Let's move towards the South Waziristan. The South Waziristan's agency has its district headquarters at Wana, South Waziristan, comprising about 6,500 square kilometers. Is the most volatile agency of Pakistan, not under the direct administration of the government of Pakistan. South Waziristan is indirectly governed by a political agent who has been either an outsider or a waziri. A system inherited from the British Raj in South Waziristan agency, there are three tribes, Wazir, Masid and Burki. Burki and Urmar is the same tribe. So here is the map shown in figure is shows the location of North and South Waziristan. The green part is the North and South Waziristan. Now let's move towards the Waziristan revolt from 1919 to 1920. In the rugged and remote region of Waziristan on British India's northwest border with Afghanistan, mountain tribes of Muslim fighters rebelled against the invading British Indian Army in numerous operations. The Waziristan revolt of 1919 to 1920 was sparked by the Afghan invasion of British India in 1919. Though the British made peace with the Afghans, the Waziri and Mahsud tribesmen gave the Imperial, almost entirely Indian forces, a very difficult fight. Some of the tribesmen were veterans of the British organized local militias that were irregular elements of the Indian Army. And used some modern Lee Enfield rifles against the Indian forces sent into Waziristan. One aspect of this conflict was the effective use of air power against the Waziris and Mahsuds. This is similar to Royal Air Force's tactics in suppressing the Arab revolt in Iraq in 1920 and 1921. Let's move towards the history of Fakir EP. The main articles of History of Fakir EP is Mirza Ali Khan Waziristan Campaign from 1936-39 and Banu Resolution in 1935-36. A Hindu-Muslim clash occurred over a Hindu girl of Banu who had married a Muslim. The tribesmen rallied around the Mirza Ali Khan, a Torikhel wazir, who was later given the title of the Fakir of AP by the British. Jihad was declared against the British. Mirza Ali Khan, with his huge Lashkar force, started a guerrilla warfare against the British forces in Waziristan. In 1938, Mirza Ali Khan shifted from AP to Gurvek, a remote village on the Durand line, where he declared an independent state and continued the raids against the British forces. In June 1947, Mirza Ali Khan, along with his allies, including the Khudai Khidmatkars and members of the Provincial Assembly, declared the Banu resolution. The resolution demanded that the Pashtuns be given a choice to have an independent state of Pashtunistan. Composing all Pashtun majority territories of British India instead of being made to join Pakistan. However, the British Raj refused to comply with the demand of this resolution. After the creation of Pakistan in August 1947, Mirza Ali Khan and his followers refused to recognize Pakistan and launched a campaign against Pakistan. They continued their guerrilla warfare against the new nation's government. He did not surrender to the government of Pakistan throughout his life. However, his popularity among the people of Waziristan declined over the years, with many jirgas in Waziristan deciding to support Pakistan. He died a natural death in 1960 in Gurvek. Let's move toward the War of Terror. In early stage of the US invasion of Afghanistan, when the Taliban started fleeing into Pakistan, the local leaders or Maliks began a campaign among their locals to host the foreigner. Since then, around 200 Maliks have been assassinated by local Taliban through targeted killings. To end the Waziristan War, Pakistan signed the Waziristan according to chieftains from the self-styled Islamic Emirate of Waziristan. On 5th September 2006, the Islamic militants in Waziristan are said to have close affiliations with the Taliban. Waziristan is often mentioned as a haven for Al-Qaeda fighters. There is speculation that some Al-Qaeda leaders have found refuge in the area controlled by the Emirate, which is staging a ground from militant operations in Afghanistan. On June 2007, the National Security Council of Pakistan met to decide the fate of Waziristan and take up a number of political and administrative issues in order to control the Talibanization of the area. The meeting was chaired by President Pervez Musharraf and attended by the Chief Minister and governors of all four provinces. They discussed the deteriorating law and order situation and the threat posed to state security. The government decided to take a number of actions to stop the Talibanization and crush the armed militancy in the tribal regions and the NWFP. Due to the ongoing military operations against the Taliban, nearly 1 lakh people have already fled to Afghanistan's host province to seek shelter. The UN and other aid agencies are helping more than 470,000 people who have been displaced from Pakistan's North Waziristan region due to the ongoing military operations. So let's move towards the conclusions. Recent study by the Islamabad-based Pakistan Institute for Conflict and Security Studies, PICS, which monitors militant activities in South Asia, Central Asia and West Asia, noted that attacks by the militants in the country dropped to 6 years low after 1 year of the Zarb-e-Azab operation. It recalled that the recorded average militants attacks had gone up to 154 per month before the start of the Zarb-e-Azab. The count dropped more than 50% to 71 attacks per month on the completion of 1 year of Zarb-e-Azab. It added that average militants attacks were presently the lowest since 2008. So here is the reference where I have researched about my today's topic. It helps me a lot. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.